Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Okay, guys, this is a very quick one. There seems to be a pattern that's emerging with all these shipwrecks that are washing ashore and have been missing for decades, if not centuries. In fact, this one disappeared in 1778, Captain James Cook's ship Endeavour has just turned up. Right, it's looking pretty pristine, by the way. That's a replica, sorry. But at any rate, it's washed up at the shores, and it had disappeared. Now, what you'll see, and this is interesting, and this is certainly something for our beloved ulama ikram to consider, is recently on the 7th of December, we also had a ghost ship from North Korea washing up in Japan, and it had skeletons inside it. In other words, it was quite a considerably old ship that had washed ashore. But it doesn't stop there. What we had during the 1st of September is another ghost ship with no one on board runs aground in Myanmar coast, right? And this ship had around about, as I understand it, a lot of containers on board. There you go. That's basically it. Let's have a look. Let's see what it's saying. That's a very large ship. So all the containers were missing, and the crew were missing, but they were washed ashore, and that's a very, very substantial ship. So where am I actually going with this? And I know that that's probably the question you guys are asking. Now, as I've maintained for a long time now, is that there's a binary star system that's merged with our solar system. I understand that binary star system to be An-Najm al-Thaqib, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, and it's something that they've been trying to hide and occlude for a long while now, and using a lot of technology in order to cloak this system, and they intend to reveal it when they're going to stage this false extraterrestrial contact. And when I say they intend to reveal it, what I mean is they will basically let the curtains fall, so all the smokes and mirrors and all that technology that they're using above our atmosphere in order to shift the focal point of these celestial bodies and hide them, they'll remove that technology so that it's apparent and it's there. Why they're going to do that is to stage this false extraterrestrial contact and maintain that these the extraterrestrial contact that they're going to stage, they're going to use Napak Jinn in order to do that, demonic entities, which will take host inside bodies. And I've discussed this with you guys of technology, cloning technology that they've got, and how they've been cloning certain humanoid beings, which eerily look similar to the alien grey beings that are depicted through these psyops and these alien Hollywood type of movies, and other, I guess, beings which will take a humanoid but lizard type form, right? Standing on 2 feet, that kind of thing. I think that these entities will take host of these bodies. And now you'll say, well, what's the connection between the ships appearing and these celestial bodies and these entities and the cloning? Well, the connection is that if you remember, and I've certainly archived a lot of content to support it, is that CERN has been set up to tear the veil, the parda, between us and this other alam, right, which is of jinn. And I understand that they're going to do this when this system makes its closest approach, in order to bring those entities into alam-e wujud, and for them to then enter and take host of these other cloned sleeves, if you want to call them, jackets, these bodies, as well as they'll seek to possess human bodies as well all over the world, especially those of us who are far removed from deen. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect and guide us. So I think, and this is going to happen around, because we understand that the jinn will be supporting and augmenting Ad-Dajjal la'natullahi alayhi. So around this time, I believe and I understand that parda Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created between them and us is going to be torn, because from at least what we understand from hadith and the traditions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that Ad-Dajjal, the Antichrist, is going to be supported by a legion of demonic entities of Napak jinn. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. I think they're getting successful, and this system, as it's drawing near, it's causing some sort of interaction, call it a cosmic, magnetic, electric interaction with Earth, and that's causing this parda to, the integrity of this parda to be undermined. And this is through the amr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as I understand it, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, right? It's not an accident, but these sort of strange going-ons which are being covered by, I mean, this is The Independent, by the way, guys. It's a mainstream paper. So it's being covered by these sort of tabloids, and it's pretty serious, and I'm seeing this pattern emerge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best again. But as I said, I understand that this war is going to be instigated soon. It's going to happen in Syria through this dialectic between Russia and her allies and America and their allies. We're going to see the Greater Israeli Project being pushed through that, and a global governance as well as an economic collapse, which will then be replaced by a universal digital currency. And during around this time, you'll see a nuclear attack, and this is when they'll stage a hoax extraterrestrial contact, which could consider them the ambassadors to the arrival of a Dajjal, the Antichrist, a prologue, as it were, to all of that. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best, and this is going to happen between the 7 years of tribulation touted in the Bible and artificially manufactured by the Shayateen in Ins and Jinn over here back on the ground. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. So the imminent arrival of our Imam, our leader, seems to be on the horizon. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. Jazakallahu khairan wa sallam jazakallahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.